Hey guys, in this video we will build the following web app from scratch. The web app will group and visualize Excel files. The user can then select the column they would like to analyze. Additionally, you have the option to download the transform Excel file as well as the interactive chart. Before coding out this web app, let me shortly show you the Excel file we will convert. We've got here the business transactions by order ID for 2020. Each order ID contains further information such as the order date, the shipping mode, product category, sales and profit amount, and so on and so forth. In our web app, we will then group the data based on the user selection. The bar chart will visualize the sales and profit situation based on the selected column. The website is written entirely in Python with the help of the Streamlit library. No HTML, CSS or JavaScript is required. Okay, and without further ado, let us get started. First things first, I will install the required libraries for this project. I will, of course, also include the requirements text file in the project folder. I will leave the link to that folder in the description box. Having said that, go ahead and type pip install streamlit in your command prompt or terminal. To aggregate the Excel data, we will be using the pandas library. To install pandas, you can type pip install pandas. Pandas also relies on the optional dependency OpenPyXL to work with Excel files. To install OpenPyXL, type pip install OpenPyXL. And last but not least, to plot our data, we will be using the plotly express library, which you can install by typing pip install plotly-express. Once we've gotten that out of the way, I will open up a blank Python file and import the libraries. So, streamlit as st, pandas as pd, and plotly express as px. Next, I will set the website title to Excel Plotter by using st.setpageconfig. On top of the website, I would like to display the title Excel Plotter. By the way, you could also include emojis in the title. Below the title, I will place a subheader. To check if everything is working so far, I will run our web app. Therefore, go back to your command prompt or terminal. Ensure that you are in the same directory as your Python file. In my case, I have stored the script on my desktop in a folder called Excel Plotter App. Next, I will type streamlit 1, followed by the name of the Python file. I have named the script app.py. After pressing enter, you should see your web app in a new browser window. Okay, and here it is, our simple web app with a page title, title, and subheader. As a next step, let us implement the file upload functionality. The upload function is pretty easy to implement in Streamlit. Back in the script, I will type that the uploaded file is equal to st.fileuploader, and for the label, I will write choose an XLSX file. To ensure that the user only uploads Excel files, I will also specify the type as XLSX. Once the user has uploaded a file, Streamlit will return the corresponding file object. Otherwise, it will return none. We could check this by typing if uploaded file. So, in case a file has been uploaded, we want to execute the following lines of code. First, I would like to display a horizontal line by using a markdown field with 3 dashes. Next, I will store the content of the Excel file in a pandas data frame. So, df is equal to pd.readExcel followed by the uploaded file. For the engine, I will use OpenPyXL. To check if everything is working, I will display the data frame by using st.dataframe. After saving the file, I will refresh the web app. I can now either use this button here to browse for a file or drag and drop a file. Once the file is uploaded, Streamlit will display the data frame. Now that this is working, let us group and aggregate the data by the different columns. Just like an Excel pivot table, you could also sum up the values by columns. In this particular example, I would be interested in the sales and profit by shipping mode, segments, category, and subcategory. However, the column selection should be made by the user. Therefore, I will insert a selection box. Back in the script, I will store the return values from the Streamlit selection in a variable called groupByColumn. I will type what would you like to analyze for the label, followed by the different options. You want to make sure that the names inside the tuple are 100% matching the column names in your Excel file. Once we know what the user would like to analyze, we will group the data frame accordingly. As I said, this will be very similar to an Excel pivot table. First, I will declare the output columns. For this example, I would only like to sum up the sales and profit columns. Next, I will create a new data frame called df underscore grouped. This new data frame will contain the Excel data, grouped by the user input, so the group by column. Additionally, I will reset the index by setting sIndex to false. This line of code would group all numerical values. However, I am only interested in the sales and profit, so our output columns. In the end, I will specify the aggregation method. In my case, I would like to sum up the values. I know this might be not very clear, therefore let me also display our new data frame in our web app. Back on the website, I will again drag and drop our Excel file. Once the data is loaded, I can now group the values by the different column. The group data frame is displayed here. To ensure that everything is working, I will go through the list and check the result for every selection. Okay, but instead of displaying the data frame, I would like to plot the data. Therefore, back in the script, I will delete the last line. To visualize the data frame, we will be using the plotly express library. I will store the plot in a variable called fig. For this example, I will be using a bar chart. The first argument is the data we want to plot, so our group data frame. On the x-axis, I will display the column from the user input, so our group by column. On the y-axis, I will show the sales. The corresponding profit should represent the color of the bars. A lower profit should be indicated as red, whereas a higher profit should be displayed as a green bar. Additionally, you could also customize the overall chart style by using different templates. I personally like the plotly white template. For the title, you could also use HTML tags. I will insert a bold text and concatenate sales and profit with the group by column name. Afterwards, I will display our plot by using st.plotlychart. Once again, let us test this out by dragging and dropping our Excel file in the web app. After the data has been uploaded, we can see our plot. This chart now provides us with valuable insights. We can easily spot that tables contribute significantly to our overall sales with around $60,000, but at the same time, they are generating negative profit. Additionally, in the selection box, we could now also inspect the other columns. The chart is also fully interactive. If you hover over the bars, you will see the actual sales and profit amount. As a next step, let us see how to download the chart and the grouped Excel data. Back in the script, I will add a download section by using a subheader. To generate a download link, I will be sheeting here. So far, there is no built-in Streamlit function to download Excel or interactive plotly charts. But after a quick Google search, I found a good solution in the Streamlit discussion forum. And I'm cheating here because I will just copy the code from the discussion board. Before showing you the code, let me shortly write out the functions, which I will define in just a second. First, I will generate the Excel download link, which takes a data frame as an input, and then the HTML download function for the plotly chart, which takes a chart figure as an input. We also need to import two more Python modules. I will import base64, and from IO, I will import string.io and bytes.io. Once again, I will now just paste the code from the Streamlit discussion board in our script. You will find the original post under the following link. There are only two things which you might want to change. The first one is the name of the downloaded file, which you can change here. And secondly, you could also change the display text of the download link. The download function for the plotly chart will be very similar. Also, here you could change the output name and the display text for the download link. Okay, now that we have our two download functions, I will save the script and head back to the web app. One more last time, I will drag and drop our Excel file here. At the bottom of the website, you will now have the option to download the Excel file and the plot. For the subcategory, the corresponding Excel file will look like this. And the chart will be downloaded as an HTML file, so that we are not losing the interactivity of the chart. Okay guys, and that's it for this video. you could now also go ahead and quickly deploy your web app to the internet for free. I have created already a tutorial to show you how to deploy your Streamlit application. I will leave the link to that video in the info card. And as always, if you have any questions, please let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching and see you next time.